All right, you're probably wondering, why is he playing that? Well, you know, there's been a lot of talk recently about alien life and about UFOs, and the Air Force has released some footage now from way back. So the question is, what does Orthodoxy think about alien life? Now, we know that we've got atheists that say that if aliens were discovered, that would be the destruction of the Christian faith and it would prove that it's not real. We've got other people that believe that the Bible doesn't say anything about it, so therefore it can't possibly exist. So what's true, what's fact, what's fiction? So I want to answer two important questions here. Number one, is alien life consistent with Orthodox Christian belief? And number two, if we assume that there are aliens, what are we to make of the concept of alien abduction? So in this first part of this two-part series, because I want to answer both questions, let's start off with the first one, which is this incompatible or inconsistent with our Orthodox Christian faith? Well, to answer this question, we're going to need a little bit of background. So first off, let's start with the statement that the Bible was written for our humanity. And since we don't know the mind of God, we don't know now what extends beyond our humanity. So God could have written other things. So that's a starting point for us. Another point is that to some extent, we already believe in alien life. Where? From the angels and the principalities. We believe that God not only created humanity, but that he also created then other beings, which are not visible to us, but we believe still exists. Now, throughout history, we've seen that the church has persecuted those people who have brought up the idea that there is some form of intelligent life that could possibly exist. An example would be Giordano Bruno. Now, he was a 16th century theologian branded as a heretic because, among other things, his belief that there is intelligent life that exists beyond our realm. And so the church then punished him for that. And even today, we have many denominations that see any kind of talk about any alien life that exists other than us to be a demonic activity. Now, that's not based on any proof or anything like that. And in fact, if we look at the biblical text itself and we look at items like the way that Isaiah described the chariot, he used his own terminology to describe that. And we could infer from that that what he saw possibly could have been an alien form. I'm not saying that it is, but we have to at least be open to those possibilities. And so what I'd like to do is offer you two quotes from two modern day theologians. One, I'm sure you'll recognize Billy Graham, and the second is the Catholic theologian Karl Rahner. Billy Graham said, "I firmly believe that there are intelligent beings like us far away in space who worship God, but we have nothing to fear from these people, for like us, they are God's creation." Now, Karl Rahner says, "As Christ is the head of all creation, and in view of the immutability of God himself and the identity of the Logos, which we would as Orthodox believe, it cannot be proved that a multiple incarnation in different histories of salvation is absolutely unthinkable. The purpose of Christian revelation is limited to the salvation of mankind and not to provide an answer to questions which really have no importance on this salvation in freedom," which is exactly what I mentioned before, is that the Bible has been written as our history and what we need for our salvation, but is not necessarily the totality of what God has done in his act of creating. And in fact, one proof of that is that we do not have anything in the Bible that tells us about who God was before creation, before ex nihilo. the Bible starts with God creating the earth, but certainly we know that God existed before time and certainly before the establishment of his creation. But then there's the whole thing of, let us make man in our own image and likeness. What do we do with that? Well, we have to be very careful, and the Orthodox Church is very, very careful about making God anthropomorphic. What do I mean by that? That God walked in the garden, therefore he has feet, and his head is shaped like us. And in fact, portraying the face of God is blasphemous. Now, I know we have a couple of icons in different churches like that, but that is a heretical and a blasphemous icon to show the face of God. So in that sense, we can't necessarily take the idea that just because the Bible says, let us create man in our image and likeness, that image and likeness could be the image of our spirit, the image of love, the image of goodness. It could be those things. So it doesn't necessarily rule out the fact that God created other intelligent life in his image and likeness, but not directly in the anthropomorphic sense that we tend to attach to God. So I guess I'll close with kind of an interesting question. So we know that through the sin of Adam and Eve, death entered the world. If we believe that there is the possibility of alien life, does that death extend then beyond our humanity, and does it fill all of creation? And so does Jesus' salvific action, is that salvation for our world, or is that salvation then for all of creation, that which we know and that which we don't know? Interesting question. While you're pondering that question, stay tuned for part 2 of our video on Orthodoxy and aliens.